Hello everyone, you're welcome back to this channel. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you how to cut a perfect collar. And trust, you're going to find this tutorial helpful. Just take your time and watch this video to the end. Thanks. So let's get started. Now, I will be using this interface to cut the collar. And I'll be folding it into two, as you can see right here. Now I'll be working with the length of 15 inches collar. So the first thing I'm going to do right here is to measure that 15 inches. I'm going to divide it by 2. So 15 divided by 2 gives me 7.5. Assuming yours is 16, it means you have to divide it by 2. Which is 8, but in this case I will be working with that of 15 inches. So like I said, you divide by 2, which gives me 7.5 or 7.5. so as you can see, I've placed it right here. So I'm going to mark 7.5 inches here. So also, I'm going to extend it a bit upward and mark 7.5 also. So the next thing I'm going to do right now is to connect this line straight, this point straight, using my ruler. So I connect. Can you see? So right now, I will now come back to this place. I will come back to this place. I will mark 0.5 upwards. Can you see? I mark 0.5 upward like this. So the next thing I'm going to do right now is to come to this line. This point here. So I'm going to mark 1.5 inch inward from this line here. I'll mark 1.5 inches inward. Can you see the mark? So having done that, the next thing I'm going to do right here is to create the collar stand button seat. So from this point, I'm going to come down. Sorry, I'm going to extend this line by 1 inch outward. So I place it exactly on that line and I mark 1 inch outward like this. So I'm going to connect this line or this point straight using my ruler. Can you see? So this is my button seat, this space here. So the next thing I'm going to do right now, on the leg of this line, I'm going to mark 1/4 inch upwards. 1/4 inch. Like this. So you could also mark, you see that you mark 1/4 inch or 0.5 inch upward. Let me mark 0.5 inch upwards here. So the next thing I'm going to do is to use my hip curve and create a curve right here. So I'll be mindful, it must touch this point here, this 0.5 by which I come up the other time. So can you see? So I'm going to draw a line across here. Can you see the line? So the next thing I'm going to do is to connect these points together like this. making sure it touches the 0.5 by which I came up the other time. And it also must touch this line here. Can you see? So the next thing I'm going to do right now is to determine the width of my collar stand. So all I'm doing here is working on the collar stand. I've not gone to the collar itself. So the next thing I will be doing on this line, I'm going to place my measuring tape. I'm going to mark the width. So I will be using 1.25. I have it here. I extend it a bit and I mark 1.25. So I'm going to connect this point together using my ruler. Can you see? So the next thing I'm going to do right now, I'm going to determine the width of my button stand, and I will be using just 1 inch. So I'm going to place it here on this point here. So I place and I mark 1 inch upwards. Can you see? So the next thing is just for me to connect this point to this. So, I'm going to connect right now, making sure that it touches this point here. Can you see? So, I'll go ahead right now to create my collar. So to determine the width, I'm going to determine the width of the collar. I will be using 2 inches for the width. So can you see? I place it on this line. So I mark 2 inches upwards. So I come to this line and I mark 2.75. So it's either you use 2 inches or you use 2.75. So I will be using, it's either you use 2 inches or you use 1.75, that is 1.75. So in order not to make the collar to be too wide, maybe I should use 1.75, that is 1.75 of an inch, that is less than 2 inches. Let me use 1.75. So I have it here. Instead of 2 inches I marked before. So here, I'm going to place, from this point here, I'm going to add 1 inch to what I measure here. So now I said I'll be using 1.75 of an inch. So 1 + 1.75 will give me 2.75. So I'm going to mark 2.75 right here. So I have it here. So it means I'm going to extend this line to connect that point first. So the next thing I'm going to do right now is to first mark a straight line, just little. Then I can now use my hip curve to complete that. So I connect together. Can you see? So the next thing I'm going to do right now is to come to this point here. I'm going to mark from here, I'm going to mark 1/4, just little, 1/4 of an inch, just to give it that effect which I want. So I'm going to connect this to this point here. So the next thing I'm going to do right now is to cut it out, tracing the line. I believe you have found this tutorial helpful. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and you hit on the notification bell so that you can have access to my video, especially the new release video. And in my channel, it's double in one, two in one. In this channel, you have opportunity to crochet different kinds of wares and also to make different kinds of wares, both male and female. So I see it as a great opportunity. So don't feel reluctant to subscribe to my channel, and you also put on your notification bell. Always put on your notification bell so that you will be notified anytime I release a new video. So like this, I cut it, tracing the line to achieve a perfect color shape. So I have, this is the color stand. Now I'm going to cut the color itself, and this is the color itself. So I'm going to trace it with this line. Can you see? So you can see that it's an easy, very easy tutorial, and something you can run just within some minutes. So it doesn't take time at all. So I'm through with cutting. Here is it. This is the down part. And here is where I'm going to place my color. Can you see? So this one left here, like I said, is the 1 inch I left for the button seat. So this is how it's going to be. So the next thing is for me to place this interface on my fabric and cut it out. But on the fabric, I'm going to leave like 0.5 for me to run a stitch on each of it. It's going to be separate, after which I now attach this to this. I hope you have found this tutorial very helpful. If you have, please give it a big thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching this video. I really appreciate. So if you have any comment, please feel free to drop your comment. And if you have any question, feel free to drop your question in the comment section. And then if you have any if you are yet to subscribe to this channel, like I said, kindly do that now. So till I come your way again, bye for now.